हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम बैक टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बायोलॉजी। एंड लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद आवर ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी, व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द लोकोमोशंस एंड मूवमेंट्स। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द ट्यूबुलर सिस्टम ऑफ स्केलेटन सिस्टम। सो इन लोकोमोशन एंड मूवमेंट येस्टरडे व्हाट वी हैड कंप्लीटेड दैट वॉज ऑल अबाउट द स्केलेटल मसल्स, स्ट्रेटेड अनस्ट्रेटेड एज वेल एज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मसल्स एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्टाइल प्रोटीन। नाउ टुडे वी विल मूव ऑन टू द ट्यूबुलर सिस्टम ऑफ स्केलेटल सिस्टम। ट्यूब्यूलर सिस्टम ऑफ स्केलेटल सिस्टम, इट इज़ द ट्रांसवर्सल ट्यूब्यूल्स, सो वी कॉल इट ऑल्सो टी ट्यूब्यूल्स, ट्रांसवर्सल ट्यूब्यूल्स, सो वी कॉल इट टी ट्यूब्यूल्स। दिस ट्रांसवर्सल ट्यूब्यूल्स, दे आर वी कैन कॉल इट, इट्स अ ह्यूज नेटवर्क विच इज़ फॉर्मिंग द ट्यूब्यूलर काइंड ऑफ द नेटवर्क। सो मेनी ट्यूब्स टूगेदर दे आर फॉर्मिंग द नेटवर्क ऑफ मायोफाइब्रिल्स एट द जंक्शन ऑफ द लाइट एंड डार्क बैंड्स। सॉरी, यस्टरडे वॉट वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दैट आइसोट्रॉपिक बैंड्स आर हैविंग ओनली द लाइट बैंड्स एंड अनआइसोट्रॉपिक्स आर हैविंग डार्क बैंड्स, इन विच टू alternative bands are there of actin protein and myosin protein. So the junction over where the actin and myosin are getting together, over their junction this network of tubular myofibrils are present. Okay, so we can write it that present at the junction of light and dark bands। जो हमारा आई है वो डार्क बैंड है, ए जो है वो लेसर डार्क, इसलिए हम उसको लाइट बैंड बोलते हैं। ओके, सो इट इज़ प्रेजेंट ओवर दैट एंड इट इज़ फॉर्मिंग अ ट्यूब्यूल टाइप ऑफ द नेटवर्क, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ नेटवर्क मेड अप ऑफ सो मेनी मायोफाइब्रिल्स, ट्यूब्यूल्स, ट्यूब्यूलर नेटवर्क। एंड दिस ट्यूब्यूलर नेटवर्क इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर प्रोविडेंस ऑफ चैनल्स थ्रू विच द इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्सिस विल बी पासिंग इन अवर मस्क्यूलर सिस्टम। Impulses pass in the surface of the interior of the muscular cell, so which will give us the signaling for the movement. So muscles will tend to move, जैसे कि आप किसी भारी चीज़ को उठा रहे हो, आप किसी चीज़ को उठाते हो तो हमारे हाथों में जो contraction आता है, so this contraction it's a kind of the electrical impulse which has been passed through this channel to our muscles of the hand, so which will give us the idea about the contraction or relaxation. Okay, so this is about the tubular system. The another tubule, rather than this T tubule, was the another tubules we are having, that is sarcoplasmic reticulum tubule. And this sarcoplasmic reticulum tubules are the smooth sarcoplasmic reticulum tubule of the muscle cell. As we know that so many muscle cells are there in our body, so in our cell skeletal system, what two tubules are there, in which one is the T tubule, which is transversal tubules. Rather than this thing, one another tubule that is called the sarcoplasmic reticulum tubules, which are smoother one. The tubules and they form the cisternae like structure, what in class 11 you people had learned about chapter cell, in which endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi bodies, they are the cisternae kind of structure, means the sac like structure. Same way the sarcoplasmic tubules are also cisternae kind of structure on the either side of the tubular network of T network or T tubules, transversal tubule. हर एक transversal tubule की either side से एक side पर जो होता है, that is the sarcoplasmic cisternae. Okay, in form of cistern. And due to which formation it there will be the establishment of a system of three tubules, which is referred as the triad complex of the tubules. Okay, so this is about the tubule system of our skeletal system. Next is sliding filament theory for the muscle contraction.
Elasticity, sensibility and excitability. So the contractile property means the contraction of the muscles due to the binding patterns of the sarcomeres and our myofibrils. They are responsible for striation of muscles, and this striation only is responsible for the sliding filament of our muscles. Okay, so this theory is basically based on changing pattern of contractile muscles of sarcomeres of myofibril. So this theory explains us that the process of the contraction of muscles, during which the thin filamentous side over thick filamentous side, means what we have learned that we are having two different kind of bands, A band and I band, and we know that in A band we are having two different kind of contractile proteins, actin protein and myosin protein, whereas in I band only myosin protein is there. So what happens? This theory tells us the same thing, that this thin and thick proteins, when they overlap, the filaments when they overlap on each other, at that time the sliding over thick, don't write it now, the sliding over thick filament and thin filament, it will be leading shortening of our myofibrils, and the shortening will again lead the muscles in both A and I band for the elasticity due to the A and I band parallel pattern or alternative pattern. So these all things will be responsible for the shortening and again to be bringing it in the original position, because the A band would be bring about in the original position, whether I band would be shorten only and H band would be disappeared. So this three bending patterns, it is responsible for the contraction of our muscle, which will be responsible for the shortening or extension of our muscles. And along with the muscles, the same organ movement would be there or displacements would be there. A band comes in the original state.
So now this in a plating elastic fiber in our I band means an isotropic band, which is called Z line, which is having central plating, because as I told you over here that A bands are getting shortened and then after again they will be coming in their original position after contractile property is followed. With the I band, they would be shortening only, and H band, they would be disappearing. So these I bands are having elastic fibers, जिसको हमने नाम दिया है Z line, and central plating, which is not overlapped by any other band, that is called the H zone. Okay. So during the muscle contraction, the myosin heads or cross bridges, they will be coming in a close contact. Okay. So which this filaments, what we have talked, that is having two different kind of globules. One is glycogen, another is myoglobin. As you know that glycogen is a source of energy storage. So this source of energy storage, here also they would be working as a serving of the energy granules only in our muscles, okay, during the contraction and extension property. And myoglobin, it is same as hemoglobin. We know that the hemoglobin is the combination of protein and metal ion. So myoglobin is also working here as a protein. So during the muscle contraction, the myosin heads or cross bridges, they will be coming in a close connection, which will be formed. Due to this close connection, there will be the formation of the thin filament, and this thin filamentous bridge type of structure, it is responsible for pooling of sarcomere, and this pooling of sarcomere is leading the shortening of our muscles or shortening of our plating. So during this plate formation, what is happening, the other thing is, as I told you that each and every plating is not responsible for each and every plate is not responsible for overlapping. Thicker bands are overlapping the thinner bands, so that the thinner band would be as it is only, na? And H bands are never getting overlapped. So this same mechanism over where in I bands the Z zone, it is having overlapping, which H band is not having overlapping in our A band. So the same mechanism will be resulting for the shortening of whole myofibril. So when whole myofibril will be shortened, so definitely whole muscles would be shortened, whole muscle fiber would be shortened, so definitely the organ would be also shortened. So from of this only we will be having the mechanism of the muscle contraction.